So once again, good morning to everyone. In the previous lecture, we have covered about what is the surface and what are the surface properties. So how the surface properties affect the entire bulk material. So that is a very important. We are modified only surface, but it will affect the entire performance of the solid. So in that, majorly we have covered about mechanical properties, chemical properties, or like physical properties. All these three will affect the entire bulk materials, but we are not modified entire bulk material, but we are trying to modify only surface. So you know that why we are talking about only the surface. We are not talking about any inside things, only outside. So why? Because always the surface is directly so like contact with this atmosphere. So there is adverse atmospheres and all the things, there is a direct effect on that. So to protect the entire materials, if you protect your surface, then obviously it will lead to protect our entire component. So that is about the your surface engineering and surface like properties. What are the what are the properties are affecting the entire surface? But in today's session, we will talk about introduction to corrosion. That is our lecture 4 in surface engineering. So I would like to share my screen. Okay. I think, is it visible now?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay. So then today we will talk about introduction to corrosion, and this is the one of very important phenomena in entire materials engineering as well as the mechanical engineering, because you know the why we are trying to study this corrosion, because you know that whatever the components you consider during our technology, we are using that different kind of metals. So nowadays we are trying to modified with FRP composites and all the things, but majorly we are always depends upon metals. But what happens whenever you are using these kind of metals, so due to small due to some environmental effects, the material definitely lost its performances due to that oxidation, like because of the oxygen presence in the air and all the things, the metal lost its performance, then obviously life of the component will comes down. So obviously what we will do, we will understand that what type of corrosion attack on that component and how to give the remedies for that. So that is the reason why we are always trying to study the corrosion, because if you don't know the principle, so what type of corrosion is attack? Sometimes there is a intergranular corrosion takes place, and sometimes there is a uniform corrosion. Sometimes there is galvanic corrosion. There is a different kind of corrosions takes place. Once you understand that phenomena, then only you can give the exact trick, like correction measurements. So you know that if you consider a generalized principles or generalized examples, once you understand that if our body feels like high temperature, so once you feel high temperature, nothing but the people understand as it is a fever. So what is the reasons, or what kind of corrective measurements to remedy for the fever, then they are giving that paracetamol. So like that, the same thing, once you understand that what type of corrosion you are getting, that then only we are giving that a proper treatment for that, because there is a lot of forms are there in the corrosions. For each and every form, there is a different kind of remedy for that. So that's why In the particular unit 1 or chapter 1, we will focus on the basic mechanism of each and every corrosion forms, so what is under syllabus, so that we will cover. Okay, so but today I would like to give only the introduction, means what is the corrosion and what is the reasons for study the corrosion, and also what are the types of corrosions and what are the factors affecting the corrosion. That is our major learning objective of today's session. So once again, I would like to recall that what is our major learning objectives of today's session is that definition of the corrosion. So you are trying to understand that what is the corrosion and why you are trying to study the corrosion, what are the reasons for that to study the corrosions, and then we will going for that what are the types of corrosions. We have different types of corrosions also there in as per the principal point of view, and finally we are going about that what are the factors affecting the corrosion. So these are the four learning objectives of today's sessions. So we would like to go for definition of this corrosion. So see, everyone know about this corrosion. So here it is a formation of the compound of pure metal by chemical reactions between metallic surfaces and its environment. So always you know that whatever the presence in the environment, you don't know either it is nitrogen or oxygen or any kind of sulfides, halogens, or any kind of compounds presence in the atmosphere, those will be react with the surface of the component. So that reaction is the chemical reactions. So because of that chemical reactions, then we are getting different kind of compounds, that is called as corrosion. So in the environmental, there is a chance to formation of like oxidation process. So that is a one kind of thing. So oxidation process loss of electrons. So obviously it will cause the loss of the materials. So everyone know, everyone familiar with this kind of corrosion process. So iron always like corrosion takes place once you keep the iron plate in the presence of air. So because of that oxygen, so you may get lost. So you people try to understand. So oxygen sometimes will help you and sometimes it will cause some damage. So for the human, oxygen will highly helpful for to live that. But in case of metals, oxygen cause lot of damage. Because of the oxygen only, all these things will happen. In sometimes, not in all the cases, sometimes oxygen will give the a good protection layer also. Okay, so then, so here, what happens, the disintegration of the metals by its surrounding chemicals through a chemical reaction on the surface of the metal is called as corrosion. So continuously because of these kind of chemical reactions happens on the surface, then obviously in the metal there is a disintegrations will be takes place, nothing but it will like partially small parts. So like that chemical reaction takes place and finally you are getting a compounds. So that kind of phenomena or that kind of process we called as corrosion. Okay. So then you can see that there is a lot of examples also there for corrosion. So here you can see that one of the general example, everyone familiar with this kind of example. So once you cut the apple, or maybe you bite the apple, so after certain period of time, so you may observe that the color it changed. So from white color to it's look like a brown color. So what is that brown color? So that is the one kind of corrosion we can simply call it is. There is a lot of reasons will be there for why it is converted into a white color to a brown color. So here it is maybe because of oxygen is the one kind of reason, and another one is that there is a special enzyme. So that enzyme is called as polyphenol. So because of polyphenol oxides, we call it as a PPO. So because of that PPO also, it is converted into brown color. Okay. So because of these kind of reasons, the white is converted into brown. But majorly, once we are like connecting with our corrosion concept, so majorly when you are cut or a bite, so you apple, if you are exposed, so that apple into atmosphere, then obviously that apple cell will react with the air. So in that particular air, there is, it contains oxygen. So this oxygen triggers the oxidation. So because of that oxidation reaction, that causes angiomatic browning. So you can see that this area, how this area changes. So this is the one kind of corrosion. Here there is oxidation takes place. Okay. And you can see that everyone metals. So it is majorly, you can see here on this particular diagram, here you are getting a uniform corrosion. So entire component gets uniform corrosion. So this is also because of presence of oxygen. Okay. So here you can see that this is the two metal corrosion. This is the very, very important, and people are, if you don't have a proper knowledge in the corrosion, then if you are giving a bad recommendations for any kind of marine applications, there is a lot of losses will be there. So here you can see that there is a bolt and there is a nut. So here bolt gets corrosion, but nothing happened to the nut. You clearly understand that. So these kind of like phenomenon occurs in that, maybe due to the galvanic effects. So C means whenever you want to select two dissimilar metals to contact each other, then definitely have to follow the EMF series. So according to that EMF series, then only you have to select suitable material. So if you also select dissimilar metals, if there is a huge difference in the electromagnetic forces like EMF, then obviously one material gets corroded and another material gets protected. Then obviously what happens, this will corrode and fail this bolt. Once the bolt gets failed, then obviously structure gets failed. So that's why the choosing of metals is very, very important in case of marine applications, because these kind of situations is always occurs in galvanic corrosion. So means there are two metals, if you are immersed these kind of two dissimilar metals into any kind of corrosive environmental, then if there is a huge difference in the EMF, then obviously one material gets corroded and another material gets protected. So this is kind of situations will occur. So means whenever you want to choose or recommend the materials, you have to follow certain guidelines. So that is the reason why I try to understand all the principles. Okay. So then the next another one is that fretting corrosion. So this kind of fretting corrosion will occur in case of bearings and gears and all the things, because due to the relative motion between the two parts, so this kind of fretting corrosion will be takes place. Okay. So see, there is another examples also there. So formation of rust on the surface of iron, we are already seen this one. That is uniform corrosion, and also there is a formation of green film on the surface of copper. So this is also one kind of corrosion. You are getting green film. So what are the major responsible factors for this corrosion of the metal? So the first one is that the metal itself. So because of the nature of the metal, so obviously the corrosion will take place. The first responsible factor is that metal itself. If it is like highly anodic material, then obviously corrosion will takes place, because if it is a noble, then nothing will happen to the material. So like that. And also there is another thing that environmental chemicals, whatever the chemicals are there, and also there is temperature and the design also. So you understand that design will also affect the corrosion. Design also will affect the corrosion. I will give a small example for that for better understanding. So when you have like a water tank, okay, so in the water tank, so whenever you would like to manufacturing a water tank here, so obviously you know that water will be there. So here water will be there. So here, so to like reduce the leakage and all the things, if you add another layer inside that, and you consider this is the one, another, this is the material one, you can consider this is the mild steel, and you consider another one is that stainless steel. You consider like this, there are the two different kind of metals. You clearly understand that there are two different metals, am I right? And these are all immersed in the water. So water is the one kind of corrosive environment. So obviously you understand that there is a two metal corrosion. So here you understand there is a two metal corrosion, two metals are there, and there is one corrosive environment. And also you understand whatever the electrolyte is there, okay, so that is in a static position. So when there is a static position of the electrolyte and there is a two dissimilar metals are there, then obviously there is a chance to occur the galvanic corrosion. So like that, whenever you want to choose a metals, you have to consider some design factors also. So design factor is that here selection of materials and all the things, okay. And also you have to choose like, so here shapes also, shape is also very important thing. Don't go for sharp edges. So sharp edges are not recommended. So because of this particular sharp edges, your water won't flow. Water will get stagnant these kind of locations. So stagnant of electrolyte causes corrosion. So either it is a crevice corrosion or it may be a galvanic corrosion. So that's why you have to avoid these kind of stagnant positions. So always your corrosion gets somewhat flow. Then obviously there is no chance to stagnant of your electrolyte. So that's why design is also one kind of very important factor in corrosion. Okay, so one is the material, whatever the metal, and also there is environmental like chemicals and temperature, so, and designs. Okay. And why the people are studying this corrosion, I think I have explained previously slide. So one is that increasing the use of metals in all the fields. So in all, not only that engineering field, in lot of fields, the people are using a lot of metals. So obviously once there is increasing the usage of metals, then obviously the another friend is there, that is corrosion. So we are not inviting that corrosion, but still it is comes with us. So that's why to protect the materials, definitely you have to study that. And different metals, then there is a chance to formation of a different kind of corrosion. So that's where definitely have to study the corrosion, how will we affect on a different kind of materials, okay. And also very important, there is a use of rare and expensive metals whose production requires special precautions. So then obviously if you are using that very different kind of materials or some expensive materials, then obviously there is another problem with that. You required very, very special precautions. And finally, and increasing the pollution of air and water are resulting in a more corrosive environment. So because of these high pollutions as well as the polluted water, so this will also causes a lot of corrosion. So then you have to understand that what is the effect of this pollution air and what is the pollution of water. So how these will be affect on corrosion. So why? Because you people think that nothing will happen to the pollution of air and pollution of water, then obviously what happens once these polluted air and water, if attack the material or component of the surface, then obviously, as compared with the pure water, the life of the component will comes down. So that's where definitely how to study that, how it will affect as compared to pure water or a pure air. So once it, if there is a lot of pollution will be there on that, then obviously there is a lot of chemical compounds may be there, those will be reacted with the component and lot of different effects will be there. So you may not be expect what kind of corrosions may be takes place inside the component or maybe outside the component. So that is the reason why you have to study the entire corrosion. Because of these reasons, the people are trying to study majorly corrosion concepts. So then we are moving to that. There is a different theories are there in corrosion. So those are all three different kind of theories. One is the acid theory. Then second one is that drier chemical corrosion, or sometimes it is called as direct corrosion also. Called it is direct corrosion. So this is the direct corrosion. And last one is that galvanic or electrochemical or galvanic, we are also called it is two metal corrosion. So there is two metal corrosion. So see, acid theory as well as the dry or chemical corrosion or direct corrosion, and last one is that electrochemical corrosion or galvanic corrosion. And there is a very important question comes from your examination, that is the what is the difference between a dry corrosion as well as the galvanic corrosion, otherwise some people are called it is also wet corrosion. Okay, then you can clearly understand that what is the dry corrosion and what is the wet corrosion. Okay, so then we will try to discuss about that what is the acid theory and what is the dry or chemical corrosion and galvanic. So see, in that acid theory, so in this particular theory majorly suggests that the corrosion of in the metal or iron due to presence of acids surround it. So if you consider this is the metal, because of any acids or oxygen or carbon dioxide, all the things, because of these things material may gets corrode. So here, according to this particular theory, you can say that iron is corroded by the atmospheric carbon dioxide or moisture and oxygens. And what kind of products you may get, you can see that FeH3O twice and FeOHCO3 and FeOH thrice. And this is the final product. This is the ferric oxide and this is the final product of your corrosion. So in the acid theory, because this is, these are also formed, but these are all unstable. This is unstable and this is unstable. And obviously, this you are getting a stable component. And you can see that what kind of chemical reactions takes place in the normal acid theory. So this is the iron and this is the carbon dioxide. And also with the presence of water, moisture and oxygen, you are getting FeH3O twice. So see, and this is not a stable. So this will be react with again water and presence of oxygen, you are getting this component. Okay. So see, this is also unstable and this will be react with water and finally you are getting two FeOH twice. And this is the stable. Okay, ferric hydroxide is this thing. So these kind of different kind of products, and this is the final product. So this is the majorly regularly we are seeing these kind of corrosion, uniform corrosion at your home. You are getting a corrosion on the grills and all the things. This is normal corrosion takes place in our surroundings because of the presence of air and all the things. And some whatever the moisture presence in the surroundings, that will takes into these particular chemical reactions. Okay. So see, then we will talk about chemical theory, also called it is dry corrosion. Okay. So this type of corrosion occurs mainly through the direct chemical action of the environmental or atmospheric gases like oxygen, halogens like hydrogen sulfides, nitrogens or anhydrous liquid sulfur dioxides with some metal surface immediate proximities. So here majorly whatever the some kind of oxides, halogens, sulfurs presence in the surroundings, because of that you can easily get like a corrosion takes place on your surfaces. So here the extent of the corrosion of the particular metal depends upon the chemical affinity of the metal toward the reactive gases. So this is also very important factor in the chemical theory. So because of the chemical affinity also between the metals. But here you can see that this is the dry corrosion. Here there is no presence of moisture. So here entirely because of oxygen, some chemical reactions will be takes place, but it is fully absence of moisture. So here there is no moisture coming into the picture. So maximum people are thinking that with the moisture only corrosion will takes place. So that is a bad opinion. So always there is a different causes will be there to form the corrosion. So this is the one of the form without moisture also there is a chance to formation of corrosions because of all oxygen, halogens or any kind of oxides, sulfurs and all the things, oxides of nitrogen also. Okay. So see, we will discuss some more details. In this kind of dry corrosion, there are three different kind of things will be there. So one is that there is oxidation corrosion, and another one is that corrosion by some other gases, majorly like hydrogen. Majorly because of the hydrogen, also there is a chance to formation of corrosion. And there is a last one is that there is a liquid metal corrosion. So, okay. So see what is this oxidation corrosion. So oxidation corrosion, which is brought about by the direct acts of like direct action of oxygen at low or high temperatures on metals, usually in the absence of moisture. So here entire corrosion takes place because of oxygen. So that's why we call it is oxidation corrosion. But here it is purely absence of moisture. Please remember that that is the major difference between dry corrosion and wet corrosion. Here we are not talking about, means there is no presence of moisture, but here because of only oxygen some oxidation reactions takes place and that will causes this entire corrosion. And also we have a second type. Is the corrosion of other gases. So other gases is majorly called about hydrogen. So because of this kind of hydrogen also some corrosion takes place, that is called as hydrogen embrittlement. So here so gases like hydrogen attack metals at ordinary temperatures, means at ambient temperatures it will directly attack on the hydrogen. So that is known as the hydrogen embrittlement, and it is somewhat dangerous. Hydrogen embrittlement, what happens, the mechanical properties of the component will vary. So what happens at the surface, the nature of the material simply change. If it is a ductile material, now it is a converted into brittle materials because of the hydrogen presence. So obviously what happens, the mechanical properties will be vary. So once if it is converted into brittle material, if you are using that component in any kind of tensile applications, then obviously what happens, your material means you consider that is initially ductile materials, but after the because of hydrogen embrittlement, the outer surface now simply converted into a brittle nature. So, but if you are using that kind of material into where exactly the tensile force is acting, so obviously what happens, your brittle material is somewhat weak in a tensile, then obviously material easily fail. So this is the reasons. Okay, that is the reason why you have to study the entire corrosion very clearly. Okay, so real time applications, there is a lot of advantages will be there once you clearly understand the principle about corrosion. So here, this is the second type in your dry corrosion, that is the corrosion by other gases like hydrogen. Due to this hydrogen attack at normal temperatures, you are getting hydrogen embrittlement. And there is a last one, that is a liquid metal corrosion in the one of the type of the dry corrosion. So liquid metal corrosion is due to a chemical action. So by chemical action caused by the flowing liquid metal at high temperature on solid metal or any alloy. So because if there is a direct contact between the metal and liquid, then there is a chance to formation of smoke corrosion. Some chemical reaction will be takes place between, because you clearly understand that here I mentioned that there is a flowing of liquid metal at high temperature on solid surface, because there is a temperature is a very important. As per Arrhenius principle, if temperature increases, obviously rate of reactions will be increases. So here, once there is a hot surface or any surface, either it is a liquid or maybe it is solids, when it very hot, then obviously there is a chance to increasing the reactions. So obviously chemical reaction will be increases. Then obviously if it is liquid, then obviously if liquid nothing but the water you consider, then obviously there is a oxygen will be there, again there is a reactions will be takes place. So due to that kind of reasons, they consider the dry corrosion classified into three different kind of things. One is that oxidation corrosion, corrosion by other gases like hydrogen, and finally it is due to the liquid. So then we will talk about a last one. So that is electrochemical or wet corrosion. So it is like a common type of corrosion of any kind of metal because of the aqueous corrosive environment. So here, so this type of corrosion occurs when the metal comes in contact with a conducting liquid or when two dissimilar or immerse dipped partially into the solution. So here it is not R. So here what you are clearly understand that when there is a two metals or two dissimilar metals, okay, so if you immerse into any kind of corrosive environmental solution, you clearly understand that. So this is our corrosive environmental. It means you consider it is a salt water or any kind of water. So and I have a component. Okay. So either it is, you can consider it is a single component, or it may be a two metal. Means if you consider this is a bolt and nut. So if you are immersed this kind of bolt and nut component into this corrosive environmental, so these kind of situations will cause us to electrochemical corrosion or wet corrosion. Okay, so definitely you required one, a conductive liquid. So you required one corrosive environment, that corrosive environmental is the liquid. Okay, so means obviously there is a presence of moisture. So according to this particular theory, there is a formation of galvanic cell. You can clearly understand galvanic cell is also called as a two metal corrosion, we already discussed. So here there is a formation of a galvanic cell. So in the galvanic cell, you know that one is that anode and another one is that cathode. So you can clearly understand in this particular example. So once you have a corrosive environment, this is our corrosive environment. So in that corrosive environmental, the component is nothing but there is bolt and nut. So there is two dissimilar metals you can consider. Then obviously what happens here, this is one of the part may act as anode and another part act as cathode. Okay, so there are two dissimilar metals are immersed into this corrosive environment. Then one is act as anode and another one is act as cathode. Once which material act as cathode, so that there is chance to corrosion takes place on the anode. So and then, so this is the protective. So your cathode material is protective. So you can see the previous example for better understand. So see here, see this particular image. So your bolt, so your nut gets protected, nuts get protected, but bolt gets corrosion. Then obviously what you can understand that this nut will act as cathode and your bolt act as anode, because this is a one of the galvanic cell effect. Okay, so one gets anode and another gets cathode. Anode gets corroded and cathode gets protected. So this kind of situations will occur in wet corrosion or electrochemical corrosion. Okay, so see what is the major differences before going to the differences between dry corrosion and wet corrosion. So here there is some chemical reactions takes place in wet and chemical corrosion, wet or electrochemical corrosion. So here some reactions takes place because one is the anode and another one is the cathode. So some reactions takes place at anode and some reactions takes place at cathode. So these are the general reactions. So at anode, so what are the reaction takes place at anode? We will see that. So here what happens, so this is also metal. So what happens, this metal convert into metal ions, means it will loss. Okay, wait. Okay, so this is the metal. So metal lost electrons. Metal lost electron, and you are getting ionized, M plus. So this is the reactions. This is the reaction takes place at anode. So always it will lose electrons. Okay. And there is another thing, that is at cathode. So what exactly happens at the cathode? At the cathode, what happens? There is reactions O2 plus 2H2O plus. So it will like release electrons. It will take electrons, 4 electrons, and you are getting 4OH-. So this is the reaction takes place at cathode. So you please remember, these are the very very important reaction takes place. Okay, so this is the reaction takes place at anode and this is the reaction takes place at cathodes. Okay, so then we are going for what are the differences between the dry corrosion as well as wet corrosion. So you know that dry corrosion, it is always the absence of moisture. But in case of wet corrosion, always you required corrosive medium or conductive medium. Corrosive medium or conductive mediums. And also here always there is a direct attack on chemicals on the metal surfaces. But here it is electrochemical cell. There is anode and there is a cathode. Some electron transformations will be takes place in the wet corrosion. But here it is not like that. There is directly chemical attack will be takes place because of all sulfides or anything. So that will directly attack, but here it is not like that because only the motion of electrons, the corrosion will take place. Here it is a very slow process as compared to wet corrosion. It is rapid process, means very huge loss will be there when there is a wet corrosion takes place. Means within short period of time, corrosion will be takes place and material gets failed. So sometimes because all the corrosion is that catastrophic failures. So definitely you have to focus on this kind of catastrophic failures. Okay. So, and also this kind of dry corrosion is like uniform corrosion. So, if it is uniform corrosion, it is okay, no problem for that, because of the uniform corrosions, you can simply predict the life of the component. That is possible by this uniform corrosion. So, and also you can take very good correct measurements also for that. So, as per that, if you predict like that, after 1 year, maybe 2 mm thickness corrosion takes place. If you predict like that, then obviously during the manufacturing, you can increase in the thickness of the component, because uniform corrosion means you are getting a uniform layer towards the thickness direction. Means in the all directions, you are getting a uniform layer. But in case of wet corrosion, is not like that. So it is a very, very different phenomenon as compared to dry corrosion. So here sometimes you are getting very small micron level pits also sometimes forms, and sometimes you are getting intergranular corrosions. Those will be takes place because of all these wet corrosions, and it always depends upon the size of the anodic part. It is very important size of the anodic part. So one, because you have two things. One is that in example nut and bolt, you compare what is the size of the nut and what is the size of the bolt. You clearly know that the bolt size is bigger than the nut size. So you understand that there is a size factor affecting the size factors. So when there is a effect of this kind of size factor, there is a huge loss in the corrosion, like in the anode part. So that's why it always depends upon the size of the anodic part. Okay. So, and in the previous slide also, I had discussed about influencing factors. So once again, I would like to give some more factors that influence in the corrosion. So one is that everyone know about this, the nature of the material. So itself, because people don't know why the color of copper is that kind of a brownish color. That is, it's a nature of that kind of metal. So because of that nature also will always causes this kind of corrosion. So why I'm talking like that, some of the metals are highly react with oxygens. So that is, it's a nature. So we can't do anything. So aluminium or iron, if you keep on outside, then obviously these are all highly reactive with oxygens. Aluminium oxides or zinc oxides or iron oxides will form that. If you keep like gold outside, gold ornament, it won't react with oxygen that much of easily. So that is the nature of oxygen, like nature of metals. So that's why the nature of metal will causes this corrosion. And also environmental. So if you protect your component with this kind of environmental, then obviously life of the component will increases. So if you use some metals in case of sea water and all the things, then obviously corrosion will be takes place. So environmental plays a major role. So because of different kind of chemical components present in the environmental. So here there is a concentration of electrolyte. This is also one of the very important factor, and temperature. So you know that if temperature is more, then chemical reactions will be more. So that's why temperature plays major role. And also there is electropotential. So this is the very important electropotential we will discuss in the majorly in galvanic corrosion. We will talk about this electropotential, how it will be affect on that. And also hydrogen over the voltage. So these are all, even hydrogen, this is all major factors influencing the corrosion. So I hope you understand what is the corrosion, so why you are studying the corrosion, and what are the different types of corrosions. I'm not talking about the forms of corrosion and different types of corrosions. There are three different types of corrosions. And also we are talking about what is the major factors that influencing the corrosion. So in the next class, we will talk about what is the different, or what are the different forms of corrosion, nothing but uniform corrosion, galvanic corrosion, pitting corrosion, stress cracking corrosion. There is a different forms of corrosions with the different kind of environmentals. So those we'll discuss in the next session. So now I would like to go for a poll question. So while I'm giving the poll question, if anybody have any doubt, you can directly ask the question. So by unmute yourself, otherwise you can post your question in the chat box. Okay. So you can see the chat box, there's a question. Is it visible, the question? So please respond. So no need to write the answer in the chat box. You please respond there. Don't write the answer in the chat box. You simply give your word there. I know the responses and all the things. I will get all the details, those who are responded. But don't write the answer. That is not ethical.